My name is Eugenia Kalnay, and I work at the University of Maryland since 2000, before I was director of the Environmental Modeling Center, which is where research is done at the National Weather Service in the US for 10 years. And before that, I worked at NASA on modeling and assimilation of satellite data. We were trying desperately at NASA to show that satellite data was useful for weather forecasting, and it was very clear that it was useful in the southern hemisphere, but not in the northern hemisphere, where sometimes the satellite seemed to help and sometimes it didn't help. The reason was that the northern hemisphere already had a large number of Raywin zone observations, balloons that are launched, and so in the northern hemisphere, the impact of satellite data, especially not optimally used, was not so large. In the southern hemisphere, it was very clear that the satellite data was essentially the only data that was helping the forecasts. So we did many forecasts and many data simulations, and it became clear to me that the forecasts were helping each other, so that when you took a mean, the uncertain parts of the forecast were wiped out or reduced, because the mean, sometimes the error was positive, sometimes negative, so on the average it was much smaller. And that effect on the mean was very clear and very indicative that we should be using ensemble forecast, even though we used many forecasts that were done for a different purpose, but it was clear. Ensemble forecasting is now an essential part of numerical weather prediction, so ensemble forecast improve numerical weather prediction, and numerical weather prediction improves the ensemble forecast, so they all go together. But coupling the ocean and the ice and the subsystems of the Earth system together as they are in reality, and coupling it with the human system, would be something which is very important, because it happens in nature, and for example, it doesn't happen in the modeling. Currently, we are not coupling enough the ocean and the atmosphere in data simulation. And the human system, which obviously dominates the weather and climate, not the weather, but the climate evolution, is not being coupled like it is in reality, and so it's very difficult to make climate predictions that are reasonable. Things are much worse than we think because of that lack of coupling. Once the Earth system affects the human system, and the human system affects the Earth system, and there are feedbacks which we don't account for right now. So that's probably then anything that we can do to improve numerical weather prediction will include ensemble forecasting. And ensemble forecasting will include NWP. Yeah. Fortunately, they are very essentially coupled now.